Inside his apartment, where he and I smoked the roach of his age and my youth for the first time since he died, examining his papers. As if on cue, the toilet explodes. The plumbing is Victorian, he'd say apologetically, instructing a guest not to flush. Only he had the right touch. I have seen enough, written on a page dated 7 years, 2 days before his death. The odor of the place clings to my clothes, the way it pervaded his books, a compound of tobacco and indefinable fragrances. For the rest of the day I track birds. Pigeons roost on my lap, a rooster runs by, a quartet of wild parrots buzz me mid-thigh at high speed. All this in downtown San Francisco. Surreality is real. Even a sparrow nearly bumps into me. Another sits next to me, contemplating me. She tells me a story. They were walking in a park when they saw two birds mating in the grass, suddenly swallowed by a lawnmower. And here are the letters he wrote to the superintendent of parks and the poems against the lawnmower. Sometimes the pages seem effortless, stretching into passages exuberant and harrowing. There were years he didn't write, yet you'd never know, seeing his papers arranged in decades. These are poets' ashes, volcanic and smoldering still. To lose this scent is to enter permanent exile.